Somewhere in your linear algebra upbringing, you were exposed to the dot product. And somewhere in that same upbringing, you were exposed to the scaling of a vector by a scalar. And how did that work? If you want to do a scalar times a vector, then that really is, you're stretching the vector by that much in the direction that the vector points. And that translates to, you just want to multiply each of the individual entries in the vector by that scalar. So this here is just 2 times minus 1, 2 times 3, 2 times 2, and what the actual answer here is not that important, and I'm going to leave myself a little bit of room. Now, when we discussed matrix-matrix multiplication, what did we notice? We liked doing the matrix-matrix multiply A times B and add the result to C. When we discussed matrix vector multiplication, what did we do? We did A times X, but we added it to Y. So here, often, we actually want to add the result of the scaling of a vector to another vector. And that just means that the result of this scaling is added to the corresponding entries in this vector. Now, what do we like to do? We like to go from concrete to more abstract. So, the general case is that you want to take a vector y and you want to update it by doing a scalar alpha times x and adding the result of that to y. Alpha indicates it's a scalar, it's a Greek letter. These here are clearly vectors because they are lowercase Roman letters. So, taking our cues from this, what does that mean? It means that if y has n entries in it, then x better have n entries in it, chi 0, chi 1, through chi n minus 1. We are multiplying that by alpha, and we're adding that to the vector y. And again, taking our cues from this concrete example, we find that the result of that is that you want to multiply the first entry of x by alpha and add that to the first entry of y, second entries, and so forth. Now, this particular operation is so important in linear algebra that it has a special name. And the special name it has is AXP. Now, where does AXP come from? AXP comes from alpha times x plus y. A X, P, Y. And this goes back to the 1950s, 60s, and 70s when Fortran ruled the world. And back then, people in our field came up with an interface called the Basic Linear Algebra Subprograms. We have an enrichment later on in this week about the BLAS. BLAS is short for Basic Linear Algebra Subprograms. And back then, Fortran 66 and Fortran 77, the standards for Fortran only allowed 6 letters to be used to identify function names, subroutine names, and variable names. And as a result, they had to be pretty innovative in the alphabet soup that they used to identify different operations. One of the operations for which they defined an interface was this AXP operation. And that's where this particular acronym comes from. Obviously, making the name of the routine alpha times x plus y would have been a little bit cumbersome anyway. So, if you hear AXP, you should immediately translate that in your mind to alpha times x plus y, updating y.